The last time the man came to the drive-in, it did not end well. He hopes to avoid that fate this time. He hopes that what he has brought with him to this place is enough.
Ugh. Serena's probably out of her mind again, but I'm gonna need that key so I can get the power back on.
To change the world, you must craft a blueprint for the new reality. Any work of art will do, as long as it's a genuine act of creation. That's what the energies of the dark place respond to. The results may be subtle and perplexing, or far-ranging and momentous. My area of expertise, the written word, gives much more precise results than music or interpretive dance would, for instance. But words can be extremely dangerous. What you define may become reality, but so can that which you imply, even if you don't realize you're doing so.
You again?
I'm really just here to get the keys so I can get the power back on.
Do you want to hold me down? It's okay. I know you like that.
Yeah, I'll just grab the keys.
I could be like your wife. Little wifey, waiting at home for hubby. Or you could be the mailman, or the neighbor.
I'm already married to someone who isn't crazy, thanks. I'm just gonna go and get the power back on.
Aww.
Look, I may or may not be back. I have the access code to the booth already, so once the power is on...
You should totally come see me. We could have fun, you know.
We'll see how it goes. You should sit down or something. Try to stay calm.
I don't want to be calm. I want to be nasty. I want to be nasty with you.
Yeah. Okay.
You could do anything you want. You can use my...
Let's not even go there. I was hoping that you'd remember more, but I guess that was too much to ask.
I was about to do the weather, but I see we have a caller. Hey, you're on the air with Eddie. What's up?
Hey, Eddie, it's Ricky. You talked about fate before. You think about that a lot?
Not a lot, to be honest, but I take it you do.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Any conclusions you'd care to share, Ricky?
Well, we've got free will, right? That's in the Bible and everything.
Yeah, right, sure.
So free will, right? Am I right? I mean, if we can do what we want, how can there be fate? I mean, you don't know what's going to happen next. So there's no fate. There's just people doing stuff.
Well, I don't know, Ricky. I don't suppose you have considered the possibility that we're all here in the service of a greater purpose, incomprehensible to us, and that what we take to be freedom is nothing more than the move of a pawn on some cosmic chessboard, limited in scope, subject to the whims of unseen players, existing only for their entertainment. Or perhaps we're just a twisted reflection of actual events that can happen elsewhere. Could it be that such is life in Night Springs?
Dude, what?
Food for thought, Ricky. Food for thought.
Thank you.
I want to talk about Alice. Just look at her. She's really beautiful, isn't she? Your wife. Well, our wife, really. Just my wife soon. Don't worry. I'm not gonna treat her like the others. She's special. If I wanted her dead, she would be. I've been around for a while now. So talented. You haven't seen her new work, of course. Oh, it takes my breath away. Really, she's that good. Did you know that I've got a wedding ring, too? We're that similar. She's seen me a couple times, you know? I've let her catch glimpses. She thinks she's imagining things, of course. She thinks you're dead. It might as well be. I mean, even if you manage to keep surviving, you'll be in my trap forever. So I'll go to her. It'll be an amazing moment. Oh my God, you're alive. I'll be the good, loving husband for as long as I can stand it. She'll love it. And then, one day, somehow, it'll happen. Maybe I'll slip up, she spots something, or maybe she just starts running her mouth. And then I'll do it. It's gonna be sweet. My darling wife.
It's obvious that for all his power, Mr. is an agent of another greater being. The dark place he came from is full of terrible alien intelligences, dark presences, and none of them should be let loose in our world. He serves one of them. He'll open the way for them if I don't stop him. But he'll do more. He'll take over my life. He already has my face. He already uses my name. He'll become Alan Wake in every way imaginable and corrupt everything. Unless I can stop him.
Like a little hamster in a wheel. Go ahead and keep running for all the good it'll do you.
Thank you.
For Serena Valdivia, burning the midnight oil was more of an exception than a rule. A procrastinator and a perfectionist, she often worked when she wouldn't be disturbed. Tonight was especially important. The film festival would open tomorrow, and there was still so much to sort out. It wasn't that the work hadn't been done. She just didn't feel like she had completely mastered everything yet.
Die, you lose. If you quit, you lose. If you make it to the end of the loop, you still lose. Sucker.
It's been 2 years since I came here. Being that long without Alice breaks my heart, and I know it broke hers. I know she thinks I'm dead. How could I blame her for that? It would be a crime to pretend that she owes me anything. She took all the stupid, self-indulgent bullshit I brought into her life and still stood by me. Still loved me. It's no betrayal. But I'm a better person now than I used to be. I want to be that person with her.
You.
I guess you're back to normal again?
I don't know if I'm ever gonna be normal, but thanks. I know you didn't have to come back for me like this.
I couldn't just leave you like that. I'm sorry about the whole thing.
Not your fault. At least I'm not Little Miss Whore Slut anymore. Ugh, that's just... Hey, thanks for not, you know, taking advantage.
No problem. You don't seem too weirded out even though this is happening again.
Honestly, that pales in comparison with having that thing inside my head. I mean, it's crazy, but...
I understand. I can really mess you up.
Plus, this is weird. I think what he did left something. I can feel that things are different. I just know that time's acting wrong. I don't know how to describe it. It's like I can sense it.
I'm not surprised. A close encounter with these forces, it stays with you. Changes the way you see things. Some people can't deal with that. They just lose it.
Well, it's early yet. I'm not ruling anything out.
I'm gonna go make my way into the projector booth.
Okay. Is there anything I can do? About the situation, I mean?
No. It's a trap for me. I'm gonna have to go deal with it.
Uh-huh. And you got a plan, is that it?
I think I have a chance. Yeah.
The Champion of Light knows that the time itself is about to end. At least for him. He can feel the dead end rushing towards him. But there is time to act. Incomplete or not, he has the weapon.
I don't have the whole thing, but maybe it's enough.
Thank you.
cute, aren't you? What are you up to? It's a waste of time, buddy. You should just lie down and die. Let me take over. This is the only thing you've got coming to you. From here to eternity.
No matter how many times you come back.
Time folds back on itself. Again, his senses scream as the very impossibility of what is happening assaults them. But the champion of light endures. Each time he gets a little closer, each time another detail falls into place. Now, the trap works against the Herald of Darkness.
What are you, the King of Hillbilly?
Thor and Odin Anderson, old gods of Asgard. I still don't quite know what to make of them. I know they used to be rock stars who modeled their stage personas after Norse gods. I know they're old. I know that in their day they fought the darkness as I do. I know they're demented and insane, ravaged by age and self-abuse. But there's something in them, something powerful that took hold when they were touched by the powers beyond. A thing that goes far beyond just stage names. Something godlike.
Right on cue. Bubbling to the surface from untold depths, the horrors come. The emerging monsters do not expect the warm reception that has already been prepared for them.
Saving Emma.
Ah!
slow as I show up, I guess.
Thanks for saving me again. I'd hate to die before I'm scheduled to be murdered.
I guess I have you to thank for setting everything up at the oil derrick.
Yeah, well, I figured that if we were going to go over this again, we might as well try to be smart about it, huh?
I appreciate it. You took a big chance doing that. Are you okay?
What do you think? I've died twice. I remember everything pretty clearly now. You said I was gonna be okay.
I don't know what happened.
Well, it's not your fault. I think one of those, what did you call them? The takers? I think they did something to the power and they got me that way.
I'm sorry.
But I got the keys from the dead guy in that room. And I'm not handing them over until you do something about this. I'm sick of getting killed.
Fair enough. You seem calmer now.
I tried freaking out. It didn't do much good for me. I guess you get used to the craziest stuff.
Good for you.
Plus I figured I'd take the edge off, you know?
Mm-hmm. Those herbal supplements are pretty good, huh?
Oh, yeah.
I wanted to try to explain things to you now since you're calmer, but maybe this isn't the best time after all.
Oh, shit, yeah. Better not get all metaphysical on me now. Seriously, I'm like two sentences away from thinking how we could all be like atoms on God's skin or something.
Or figments of somebody's imagination?
I'm just gonna try to chill out and not think about that or getting murdered or anything, if you're cool with that.
Gotcha.
Emma wasn't sure exactly when the man arrived at the motel, but from what she could tell, the party started almost immediately. It was infectious, spreading from one room to another. He was mercurial, almost as if he was flickering through the scene, telling a joke here, throwing an insult there, oozing sex and violence and excitement. She had never seen someone like this before. He looked at her and smiled, and she felt her heart flutter a little. She knew he was the kind of man mothers warn their daughters about, but she told herself it didn't matter.
So I've been thinking about Barry. I don't know what to do about him yet. I mean, I'm not gonna keep him around, that's for sure. Al? Al? Ugh, little parasite. Your best friend. Really? That's the best you can do. I actually kinda like the guy. He's a plucky little butterball. He plays the clown. That's a hard road to take. But I don't need him sticking his fat face in my business. Did you know he's been hanging out with the sheriff from that shitty little town? They keep in touch. Barry's about the only guy who insists that you're not dead. How about that? I might keep him alive for a while. Just to see him go to pieces when I fire his ass. Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
art lovers, are you feeling neglected? You shouldn't. You know Eddie Rodman's got love for you, which is why I actually hauled myself out of bed before noon, just so I could record an interview for your pleasure. Enjoy. Now, as I'm sure you all know, the annual Night Springs Visual Arts Show is coming around again, and that's a big deal for all of us that are in the culture business. If you can call it a business, that's a little controversial, I know.
Oh, that's okay. Money makes the world go around, no doubt about it.
And that's one of my guests here at the studio, Serena Valdivia. She's a curator at the Night Springs Gallery of Visual Arts, and she's in charge of the NSVA Film Festival, held this year at the old Night Springs Drive-In Theater.
Hello, Eddie. It's great to be here. And let me just say that it's a wonderful venue.
Absolutely. And with her is one of the filmmakers, somebody who's actually primarily known as a renowned photographer, Alice Wake.
Hello.
Alice, I've seen a lot of your work over the years. It's very impressive. My wife's a big fan, actually.
Oh, thank you.
You've gained quite a bit of fame as a photographer, but that's not why you're here, right? You actually have a film. That's a little surprising.
For me, too. I really wouldn't be here at all if it weren't for Serena.
You two are friends, I take it?
Yeah, we move in the same circles. So about a year ago, I heard about all this footage she'd shot, and I got to see some of it, and then I started pestering her about actually putting it out there, because it was really good.
I didn't really want to show it. It felt too personal.
Well, yes, I can understand that. It features your husband, and he's, well...
He's dead.
I thought he was missing.
It's been 2 years. This sounds awful, but yes, I believe he's dead. Otherwise, he would have... Well, you know.
Yeah, I understand. Well, hold that thought, and we'll be right back.
I have seen the darkness twist flesh into new shapes before. But encountering these giants is an extremely disturbing experience. It's as if the genre has been switched on me. There's something out of Pulp Fiction. Twice as tall as normal men and stronger than forklifts, their lumbering gait and slow-witted demeanor brings to mind some kind of mean-spirited caricature of a feeble-minded hillbilly.
Okay. I really don't think they can get to the power now.
Thank you. That's a relief. Here's the keys that you needed.
Thank you.
Hey, I have to tell you, at the diner, I went there with him, the guy who looks like you, okay? I know I said that I didn't.
Yeah, I figured. Want to talk about what happened at the diner?
There was this guy from the observatory, and... he just attacked the poor dude, smashed his face into the tabletop a bunch of times. It was horrible. I didn't know that he was gonna do that. I swear. And I just ran. I just left him there. I didn't even try to help.
There was nothing you could have done. It's not your fault.
Well, he's dead in that motel room now, so excuse me if I feel pretty shitty about it anyway.
You shouldn't blame yourself.
I just didn't want to get involved. I have this tendency to just... drop everything and run. I don't think I'm a bad person, but I didn't even call the cops. I'm such a coward.
If you'd called the cops, we'd have dead cops. He's not human. Do you understand? It's not your fault.
But I could have tried to stop him.
Believe me, if you had, you'd be dead. You seem to be doing a little better now.
Yeah, I guess it just got easier once I got this thing off my chest. I just feel so guilty about it, especially because I didn't pick up on any of the warning signs. I just really liked hanging out with him, you know? He was smart and charming and funny and hot. The way you could be, I guess.
I guess.
What's the deal with this guy anyway? He looks like you, he uses your name. Why does he do this stuff?
I'm not sure myself. Maybe he's just evil or my dark half. He does a lot of the stuff I'm trying really hard to get away from. Things that just messed up my life.
I guess all those murders don't help either.
Yeah, I could do without the murders and the end of the world. Listen, I need to get going.
Yeah, go. I think I'm good now, I hope.
Good luck. If it all goes well, maybe this is the last time we meet like this.
God, wouldn't that be great?
Just keep those lights on, okay?
Getting the Andersons into the recording studio was a struggle and a half. But once they actually picked up the instruments, something happened. They were two old men, and they weren't. They were doddering bags of bone, and they were barely contained power. And there was music. Barry rubbed his hands together. He knew how to pick a winner. Now all they needed was some direction on how to make things a little more modern. Barry had never produced a thing in his life, but he knew what he liked. He knew Balance Slays the Demon was going to be a hit.
The fate of countless individuals hangs in the balance, threatened by the machinations of the Herald of Darkness. And yet, for a moment, the Champion of Light breathes a little easier. He has saved one life. For this moment, it is enough. And soon, perhaps, he can put an end to this. Returning to the observatory for what he hopes is the final time, the man feels anticipation and dread in equal measure. Soon, he knows, he will have what he needs